Hello everyone! In this video, I'll be going over how I paint a star, with some insights into my thought process along the way. There's a little bit of thermodynamics and stellar structure involved, but shouldn't be anything too complicated. To make a star, I'll start with a base of a bright solid color, either white or close to it, then stipple additional layers of color on top in a fractal pattern to give it a feeling of depth and three-dimensionality. Since I'm making an incredibly hot B-type star here, I start with a base of titanium white and build up different layers of blue on top. The colors come from thermodynamics. Stars are approximately black bodies, so we can calculate the amount of light they put out across the spectrum and use that to figure out roughly what color they'd appear. There's some artistic license involved, since stars are so bright they mostly just appear white, but it makes the painting more visually interesting and it does have a basis in physics. Now that I have a good base, I'll start building up layers of color to give some depth to the star's atmosphere. I'll be using a deerfoot brush which has all its hairs coming to a flat plane, making it excellent for getting wispy looking effects using stippling. For a hot star of spectral class B, I start with a light blue and work my way up to darker and more saturated blues. For the first layer, I'm using cobalt blue, lightened with titanium white. I was trying it out for the first time in this project, and I'm really happy with how it looks. It didn't seem to shift hues at all when I lightened it. Stars are affected by a phenomenon called the limb darkening effect, which is where the edges of stars are less bright than the centers of their disks. To mimic this effect, I'm preferentially stippling blue around the edges rather than the center, which gives the edges a feeling of being slightly darker and cooler. The splotches of color should be sort of fractally distributed, which is where things look similar on different scales. It's very often how things appear in nature, such as cracks in dried mud or the branches of a tree. For the next layer of blue, I used ultramarine, again lightened with titanium white. Looking at the finished product, it seems like ultramarine might have a slight red tint to it, making the mixture very slightly purplish. I'm not unhappy with it, but it wasn't quite what I had in mind. Again, I'm preferentially putting this new layer of blue around the edges and in places where I've already placed the first coat of blue. This helps give an illusion of regions in the star's atmosphere with varying temperatures. I do still put some directly on the white background in places, just sparingly. Check the end of the video for a concise visual guide to the colors I'd picked to represent the various spectral classes of stars. For the third and final layer of blue, I used thalo blue, which surprised me with a slight greenish shift, though not enough to be a problem. I've also been mixing in some iridescent medium with the various colors, which makes the entire star reflect a lot more light and seem brighter. And as a final step, I go around the edge and draw out some wispy-looking strokes to give that feeling of the star's atmosphere streaming out into space. This would obviously be far too faint to see while also seeing the full disk, but that's what artistic license is for. And that's pretty much it, barring the last few little touch-ups. Here's a photo of the final painting, showing how that iridescent medium really makes it shine, and how the different color layers give it a three-dimensional appearance. And here's a little chart showing the rough colors I'd use to paint stars of different spectral classes. Good luck painting your own stars, and don't be afraid to experiment and try out your own ideas.